Welcome to the Folktale Project. This is Dan Scholes. This week, we're headed to Armenia for three new tales from the Golden Maiden and other folktales and fairy stories told in Armenia by A.J. Seklemian. This first story is a tale that we've heard before, not this particular tale or version of it from Armenia, but it's a story that should be extremely familiar about knowledge and wisdom and where it should be found. In this particular case, I like the way that it's treated at the end. This is A Wise Weaver. A king was once sitting upon his throne when an ambassador from a distant country approached, drew a line around the throne, and sat down without speaking a word. The king did not understand the mystery. He called his ministers. They also did not understand it. It was a disgrace to the king that he did not have a man wise enough to understand the symbolical message of a neighboring sovereign. The king was very angry, and ordered his ministers to solve the riddles themselves, or to find someone in the city to solve it immediately. Otherwise, he would put them all to death. Thereupon, the ministers began to search through the realm for a wise man. After a long quest, they came to a certain house, which they entered. There was no one in the first room but a baby sleeping in a cradle. And strange to say, the cradle was rocking without any visible cause. They entered the adjacent room, and lo, there was also a baby sleeping in a cradle, which was rocking, though no one was in the room. They walked out into the backyard, where they saw wheat washed and spread to dry. There was a cane moving to and fro, driving away the sparrows, in order that they may not eat the wheat. The ministers of the king were surprised, and going down into the cellar, they found a weaver weaving cloth. As his wife had died soon after giving birth to twins, he had both to weave for his living and do a housewife's work and nurse his children. He therefore had connected the two cradles and the sparrow driver to his loom and shuttle with cords. And so in this manner, by virtue of his cleverness, he was performing all his duties without much trouble. The ministers thought that this man might solve the king's riddle, so they told him what had happened. The weaver thought a while, and then, taking a couple of marbles and a chicken, went with the ministers. Entering the presence of the king, he looked the foreign ambassador in the face and threw before him the marbles. The ambassador took from his pocket a handful of grain and spread it on the floor. The weaver put down the chicken, which in a few minutes ate all the grain. Thereupon, the ambassador put on his sandals and ran speedily away. "What was all this?" asked the king. "By drawing the line around the throne," answered the weaver. "The ambassador wished to say that their king was coming to besiege us if we did not humiliate ourselves and pay tribute. To this I answered by dropping marbles, which meant that they were children compared to ourselves, and that they would better go and play marbles rather than undertake a war which would result in their utter ruin. By spreading the handful of grain, he meant that their forces were innumerable. By the chicken, which ate all the grain, I meant that a company of ours was enough to destroy a legion of theirs." The king was pleased with the weaver and gave him costly presents. But the weaver only took a little to enable him to bring up his beloved twins. The king wanted to make him prime minister, but the weaver declined, saying, "Let me continue to be a weaver, only I beg you to remember that wisdom and understanding are not distributed according to rank, and that the common tradesmen are entitled to be treated as humanely as your peers and noblemen." And that is the Armenian tale of A Wise Weaver. Again, this is a familiar story. It's one that we've heard more than once and in more than one region. But I like both the ingenuity shown by this weaver in his pulleys and threads to rock the babies, scare the birds, and continue his weaving. But also, I like how forthright he is at the end in declining the prime ministership and stating that knowledge and wisdom are not synonymous with rank. Look everywhere if you want to find the best, not just in the wealthy and privileged. This is Dan Scholes for the Folktale Project. Don't forget that you can subscribe to the podcast on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, Google Play, Overcast, anywhere you like to get your podcasts. You can follow us on Twitter at Folktale Project. You can find us on Auto Radio, TuneIn Radio, iHeartRadio, Spotify, anywhere you like to listen. And you can always head over to folktaleproject.com, where you'll find a new story waiting for you every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Don't forget that if you'd like to help support the podcast, you can head over to patreon.com/folktaleproject, where for as little as $1 a month, you can get early access to every story told. As always, thank you so much for listening.